Hi everyone, this is Sunny Kumar from IITBHU and welcome to my channel Code with Sunny. And today I'm going to discuss the problem add one row to tree, index number is 623 and the problem is of medium type of lead code. Okay, so let's jump directly to the problem statement. We have been given the root of a binary tree and the value v and the depth d. Okay, and we need to add a row of nodes with value v at a given depth d. So basically we are going to insert n number of nodes, let's say some nodes at a given depth d, and each node will contain the value v. Okay, and the root node is at depth equal to 1, and the rules are given here. So I'm not going to read out the rules, I'm going to explain these rules with the help of the example. So let's move to the example first. So this is a binary tree, as you can see here. Now according to the problem statement, this is the depth equal to 1, I'm going to write d equal to 1, and these nodes with values 8 and 7 are depth equal to 2, and similarly this will be at depth equal to 3. Okay, now we have been given the value of v and the value of d. D will signify the, we have to insert certain amount of nodes at the depth equal to d, and all the nodes below that will be shifted to one more depth. Okay, and each node will have the value equal to v. Now how we are going to do this operation and what are the sequence of operations for various values of d, so let's understand that also. Okay, so let me first change the color. Okay, now suppose we have been given the value something v, and let's say d equal to 1. I am going to fix the value of d. Okay, d equal to 1. Now it means that we have to insert the d equal to 1, that is a node with the depth equal to 1. It means we are going to make our new node as the root node, and all the nodes that is below that, that is 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4 and 3, are going to be shifted by 1 downward. So what will be our new node, new binary tree? It will be like, let me first replace this. So I have a node with value v1 that will be at depth equal to 1, and all the nodes that are going to be below that. Note that if I'm going to insert a node with insert a node at the root node, so 9 will be shifted to the left subtree, and its right subtree will be as empty, and all the nodes below the subtree of this root node 9 are going to be same as it is for the previous binary tree. Because you can see that this example statement says that if depth d is 1, that means there is no depth d minus 1 at all, then create a tree node with value v as the new root of the whole original tree, and the original tree is the new root's left subtree. So 9 will be the left subtree of v. Okay, and what about, we are going to make some values of d. Let's say I'm going to erase this one. So okay, now I'm going to modify this my value. Let's say for general d, let's say 3. So it means we are going to insert at depth equal to d the certain number of nodes, and all the nodes below that are going to be shifted downwards with depth more than with increasing depth, and it will be incremented by 1. Okay, so it means this is at depth equal to 1, and this is at depth equal to 2, and this is at depth equal to 3. Means we are going to insert the nodes at this depth, and all these nodes 6, 5, 4, 3 is going to be moved towards downwards. Okay, so our new tree would be like 9, and here it will be 8, and here it will be 7. And what about 6 and 5? Note that 6 and 5 will be at one more increasing depth. Before that we are going to insert two nodes. And what are these two nodes? Okay, so note that for according to the rules, we are going to insert two nodes. That is, if left the nodes of, that is, 8's left subtree will be of v value v, and again 8 right subtree will be of value v, and the v's left subtree would be the node 6, and v's right subtree would be the of null, and similarly this right node of node value equal to 8 has the node v. Now v's right subtree will be of 5, and v's left subtree will be of null. I'm going to denote it by n. And similarly for the node 7, there is at the original binary tree, you can see 4 and 3 is present, but these are going to be shifted to one more depth. So what will be the child nodes of 7? So child nodes of 7 will be 2 nodes. And what are these 2 nodes? They are 2 nodes of value V. And again, this will be of value V. And what are the child nodes of these 2 nodes? According to the rule, those nodes which are left child of 7 in the original tree will be the left child of V also. So it will be of like 4, and 4's right child, that is V's right child, will be null. And similarly, for the right child of 7, you can see a node V is present. So its right child will be the 3, and what will be its left child? Left child will be null. Okay, I'm going to denote it by N, this also N. Okay, so basically what I'm going to do, I'm going to first go back to that level, go back to that depth from which we are going to insert my new nodes at that increasing depth. That is, if I am going to insert nodes at d equal to 3, that is at this value, I am going to come at d equal to 2 and store all these nodes in a, let's say, vector or queue, and then I am going to process my new nodes, that is make my new nodes, and assign the left child and right child of my current node, and also modify these or child nodes of the original tree, okay, to the suitable depth. Okay, so this is the main logic. So let's move further to code this in most efficient way. Okay, so let's move further. So I'm going to do this. So let's change the value. Okay, for the base case, let me write if b equal to 1. Okay, b is equal to 1. I'm going to first make a tree node. The node equals whose value will be like 2, whose value will be assigned as b. And it's note that if d equal to 1, then our new node will be the root node, and for the root node of the original binary tree, it will be the subtree of my left subtree of my new node. So I'm going to write nodes left exactly equal to root. And what about nodes right? Nodes right will be null, and simply return the node. I'm going to return the node here. Okay, so this was the for d equal to 1. So this I have to write for the base case, so that there might not be any errors further in for general case. Now I'm going to write for any general d. So what I'm going to do, let's make a q here first. Q node star. I'm going to write q node star. Okay, it is of type tree node. Okay, so q node tree node star and q. Okay, and let me push this root node. Now let us iterate for int I equals, I think I have missed something, I would tree node v for int. Okay, this is right. So for int I equals, okay, I'm going to make some changes first. Now I'm going to write for int I equals 1, I less than equal, I am going to iterate for less than d minus 1, and this d minus 1, and this I plus plus. Okay, why I'm going to iterate up to d minus 1? Note that I'm going to iterate up to d minus 1 because let's suppose I have the value equal to d equal to 2, then this for loop will not run. Then I have all the nodes at the level d minus 1. This is what we want. And suppose I have d equal to 3. So this loop will run one time. So I have all the nodes that are at level equal to 2. That is the child node of this root node of the original binary tree. Okay. So what I'm going to do here, let me make a size variable that is storing the q dot size. Okay. So I'm going to loop till size is non-negative. Okay, so I'm going to push make a new node, pre node, start node, and it will take the queue.front. And I'm going to pop out this queue, and if nodes left is still existing and it is not equal to null, I'm going to push queue.push nodes left. Okay, and what about nodes right? Okay, I'm just going to check nodes right. If nodes right is not null, I'm going to push it in my queue. That is nodes right. Okay, I forgot semicolon here. Okay, so I'm going to push to nodes right. So what this will done is, after this for a given D, the queue will have all the nodes for the level D minus 1. So if we get all the nodes for the level D minus 1, we can quickly assign the nodes, that is new nodes, for the level D with the value V. Okay, so this gives us all the nodes at the level D minus 1. So I'm going to write the single statement. This gives all the nodes at the level D minus 1. So if we also consider one thing, that is how many times this loop will run. Note that for the outer loop, that is D minus 1, in worst case it will run up to log of, for a given n nodes of the binary tree, it will run up log of n times. And what about this inner loop? For a given binary tree with n nodes, it will run for a particular level, let's say at the maximum depth, it will have a nodes of something like 2 power d minus 1. Or it will have the, so how many times this loop will run in total? So it will be like log of n into 2 power d minus 1. Okay, so we are not going to discuss about that. So let's move further. So we are going to insert the new nodes at the level d now, because we have all the nodes at the level equal to d minus 1. So let's make new nodes. I'm going to write while not equal to q.empty. So I'm going to pick up every time each node, and let's try to make a new node. Okay, so I'm first going to write tree node. Okay, let me write a variable current that is going to signify I have the current node. Okay, let me pop it out first. Okay, I'm going to also make a tree node, new node. Let me denote it as new node 1, and it will have, well, it will have like new tree node V with the value V. Okay, so it will initialize with the value V, DV. Okay, so let me copy this and directly paste this one at the below. Okay, so I'm going to denote it as again new node 2. Note that what I'm going to assign the values to new node 1 and new node 2, and what will be the pointer here. So please note that also. Okay, I have something called here. Okay, okay. Now, okay, so I am going to signify the values, that is new nodes one left will be the current left. Okay, new nodes one's left will be current's left. And what about new nodes right? According to the problem description, new nodes right will be null simply. And what about current's left after we have made the new node 1? Current's left will be new node 1. Okay, so basically this is nothing but if we analyze this carefully, so I'm going to insert here, let's say I'm going to insert here a single node. So this is my new node. So if I'm going to insert this new node here, so what is, so the, my previous node is this. So this left is this one, and this left is this one. And what about this right? This right is null. And I'm going to talk about this right one also now. Okay, so this was for the left node. Okay, so what about my new node 2? So my new node 2 left will be simply as null according to the problem statement. What about my new node to's write. So my new note to write will be simply currents write. And if I have made my new note, so what about the currents write? It will be modified. Currents write will be new note to simply. Okay. So this was the basic modification I need to do here. Okay. So I think I have done with these steps. I have inserted all the nodes for the required D. So let me return the root node. So let's run this code first and check it out if this is going to be a true or what. There is something undeclared identifier new node at line 54. Okay, I've missed something. I think I should write here new node 1. Okay, no problem. There is another compilation error. Oh, sorry. I have missed. Okay. Okay. So let me run this code again. Compile this code. I think it should. Yes. Okay. Let me submit this code now. Yes, it is runtime is 16 ms and faster than 90.51% of C++ online submissions. So if you have any doubts, do not forget to mention in the comment section of the video, and I will ask the viewers to like this video, share this video, and the link to the code is mentioned in the description section of the video, and do subscribe to my YouTube channel for latest updates. Thank you for watching this video.